Thomas Hock. I am a sports scientist and I'm working for the company Semi-Reality Motion Systems. And we are a company based in Germany, in Munich. And we are developers, so we are software developers. I thought about when I'm traveling to Luxembourg, I thought about how can I start this presentation. We all have a dream, and this with a sentence I want to start. And the dream is we want to enhance our athletes' movements, that our athletes can win gold medals, that they can be proud of themselves. We want to give you the possibility to make it as easy as possible to have an idea of how can I train my athlete? What kind of performance parameters do I have to work on? If we are looking at these kind of parameters, so there are a lot of, but I'm just giving just three things. There is just one, it's tactics and behavior. It's coming more from the psychological side. How can I react to my opponent? How he's playing? How can I adapt my play to this opponent? Then there is, of course, the physiology, like the muscles and skeletal system, which kind of training methods do I have to use for especially table tennis or for top spin, or where do I have to focus my training on that. The third way, there's a technique, so it's coming from the motorical side, like how well or how good can I, or is my athlete able to perform a very optimized technique of a top spin or a backhand or something like that. And normally these three kind of performance parameters are being analyzed on their own. So we have a guy who is responsible for the tactics, counting just like how many ball strikes we have, or is it how many forehands, how many backhands, something like that. So there can be a very huge list of attributes where we can get out of our opponent, also of our own athletes, to adapt the tactics. We also have the technique, so we can use some kind of methods all over the world within research institutes. Also, just one camera we have here with high speed or with a very good resolution and with high frame rates, so that also like very high movement or high speed movement of players in table tennis can be clearly visualized on the video stream. And normally, as I said, these kind of parameters are analyzed on their own. But what is important, the tactics is influenced by the technique, and the technique is influenced by the physiology. So why do we analyze this on their own and bring together at the end? And we can also analyze everything together. And this is what our system can do. And there are many different methods we can use for that. And especially, it's very easy to assess that. And if you are going into the applied sports science, we have two kind of areas where we want to get information out. At first, we want to get out in training. So how good is our athlete training or is performing a specific way of moving? We also can get out information. So we have many methods right here. So we can go to research institutes and biomechanics labs, or we can use like just video camera to get out the information. And on the other hand, this might be the more interesting point. We also want to know how good is my athlete in the competition, and can he reach the kind of technique we're training all the time also in the competition? And when not, why is it so? So there are a lot of questions who cannot be answered right now because it wasn't possible. At first, we can use just a camera, like here, just a video camera, or just a photo to describe a movement. So it's just like, okay, this is a forehand, okay? And then there could be a question, so what kind of shot does my opponent do before? And how was the reaction of my athlete? But this is just like a static information. If we're using just a video with very high frame rates, we can also draw in angles on some specific points. We can also get out information there, but it's just one video. And one video is not very accurately, because in table tennis, we are working in three planes. So just like behind and left and up and down. So if we have not only one plane, we have three planes where we have to analyze on. And therefore, we need 3D information to very, very precise describe our athlete's movements. And for that, the most used techniques are called motion capture systems. And I think all of you know these systems or just somewhere tried it out at some biomechanics labs or institutes. And there are two kind of systems right now on the market, also within our system. And the first is the marker-based motion capture, where just like some kind of markers, like here, are attached to the body. And if you want to capture your whole body movements, you need at least like 50 markers on the body. It takes 1 hour to put on, so it's a lot of time. Just put it on myself, but you can see that. So I'm just putting it on. And so of course you have to just put them very precise on your joint segments because you want to calculate the inverse kinematics, so the joint centers. And this is what normally an arm looks like. It's just the underarm, not the upper arm. And as you know, in training it could be good, but it interrupts you in your movement because you have all the markers on your whole body. You cannot do it in competition because it looks a little bit funny and stupid, and you can't do that because it's not allowed. And also, if you have very high-speed movements, or you are sweating a lot, normally the markers, if you have a very fast movement, the markers fell off if you're sweating a lot. So data is completely not available. This is a method 20 years old right now, and it's also used in many kind of institutes in biomechanics. And it's a good method because it's very good described, but if you want to use it in the applied sports science, it takes too much time to do that. And then there is another method, actually very new, and there are many developers out there who are providing that. And these are not our own, but we can do that in our software. It's an IMU system. It's inertial measurement unit. It's like called also variables in sport. It's like very common in the media right now. And this has not to be placed accurately on some joints. So you just put it on your segment, like the hand or your underarm. Like here, and you can also like calculate joint kinematics out of that. But for elbow angle, I would need just one more, something like that. So this is another method. There are some suits who have cables in there to cover that, so this could also be possible. But of course, that's also a method which can be used in competition, and also like you can try it out later. If you do a very fast hit, this would thing would fall off. Of course, these kind of methods are available and you can use that. If we're talking about the applied sports science, we have to get another method which allows us to really do it and use it also in sports or in your training or in your analysis. And therefore, we developed a system which is right now unique on the world. So we are the only company providing that in this kind of application. And this is called markerless motion capture. And we also call that silhouette-based motion capture because we are not measuring a marker and we are not measuring a sensor. We are measuring just the human body. You can clearly imagine that. So this is me within my person, and there is a silhouette over it. And we have many cameras out there. So I will show that to you later in a project. We can calculate a 3D silhouette, okay, it's like an animation figure. And within this kind of silhouette, we have joint positions and joint centers, and we can get out biomechanical information out of that. And here is a little picture how we're doing that. So we place some specific cameras, it's 4 up to 8 cameras around the table or around the area where the player is moving in. And this was before markers, and now we are using like a silhouette of the body, and we get out all the information about joint angles, joint velocities, joint accelerations, and so on, and without putting any markers on and in very fast time. And how that looks like at the end, so this is a data sheet of a table tennis project we've done with the table tennis club from FC Bayern Munich. So we just go there with the camera system, said, okay, you can play, and we're just recording some videos. So they do not know what we are doing. That's quite funny. What you see here, so we're just capturing also the ball's movement, where the ball strikes the ground. So this is for tactical analysis. We can also count on how many forehand and backhand or some other attributes for statistical analysis. And we have also the 3D information of the body, in which kind of position or which kind of elbow angle the player touches the ball, something like that. And how good was the impulse from the elbow at the ankle or from the hip? Or is there something missing in this follow-up, in this line? So this is what it can look like. Depends on what kind of parameters are important for you, because we are not the table tennis experts. We're just experts in getting out information. You guys, you are the experts in what kind of parameters are important for table tennis, and which what kind of parameters we can use it for training, and we can do some table tennis optimizations. And we will just go into a project right now. So this is how our system is looking like. And we have placed some cameras around the tables here. And all cameras are synchronized to each other. So if I'm just scrolling through the video, you will see they're all synchronized. So this is the first thing you can use. So you can use just the video feedback. So what we captured here is just within 250 frames per second. So you can use that for your analysis. And it's also important to get back the information to your athlete, because the athlete cannot use information of data. You also have to give all the information you will get out within this system back to the athlete, while visualizing this very correctly and very good. So this is the first thing you will get out. In the next step, we can follow the ball. This is visualized here. So we just capture the ball's movement. And here we get the ball's velocity, we get the way. We can also use the information of the set axis. If the set axis is zero, the ball strikes the table, so we can count where the ball struck the table, and we can count how fast the ball was at the maximum speed. So we can count that. And yeah, well, here are some more this kind of information. Okay, and then we can also use these cameras to get out the 3D information. And I will just show it to you on that. So this is a skeleton of this guy here we analyzed. So I just go through the same view. And this is actually the movement of the guy. And we have an accuracy of a sub-millimeter. So it's a very precise movement analysis tool. This is what we can do. And of course, we can also get out the information on that specific kind of hits. So this is just an example of the type of data we will get out of that. So this is just the speed of the segment and joint centers. Okay, so the speed of the elbow, the shoulder, the hip on the left side, because here the racket on the left side, and the wrist. And what you see here is just go on that. So what you see here is the place where he stroked the ball was here. Can see that in this picture also, and this is how good he stroked the ball. Okay, so normally if you have in mind the biomechanics of a topspin, it should not look like this. So there should be a good impulse from the left side over the shoulder and the elbow and the wrist, and in the best way he would stroke the ball in the maximum hand velocity. And this is what you can get out very easily within our system. And you can just do it in a specific template. So you also have this, always have this kind of template in your system, but you can also like calculate the center of gravity's movement. You can also calculate how many steps am I doing, or the distance between the two angles, something like that. So you have a lot of data you can get within our system. And what you just have to think about, what kind of data is very interesting for me and what kind of data can I use to optimize my athlete's performance. You can use it on your own, or we can use it. So you just have to get a camera system, and you send off the videos from the camera system. So you just press start and stop, and all these kind of these videos come to a platform, and we're just analyzing it. We will give you a special template data sheet, and this data sheet you can use for your optimization. So that is not your work to also be the guy who is able to use that kind of system. You're only the guy who is able to interpret the data. And this might be the best way of using such a system. Let's go to a specific point somewhere here. And just overlay the skeleton here in that mannequin here. So So what you see here is just the guy here. Okay. We have this 3D information, and it's quite the guy here. So we're measuring really the human performance, not such like a Kinect camera or something like that. Well, you can use that information for optimizing your sports performance. There is a big data, and what is very interesting is you can use it in combination. So you can use the tactical analysis tool to calculate like the ball strikes or how many kind of hits is the player able to do. And you can also use kinematic information for that. So if my player is doing like this kind of movement, for me it's a top spin, or it's a front hand. And this is clearly can clearly be described out of the kinematics. So you can also use kinematic values. And the next interesting point is that you can also analyze your opponent. And you can get the idea what why do I lose the game? Is it more the tactical side? Was it like aside from the technique? Is it a failure I'm always doing when I'm losing or when I'm winning? So you will get a very clear insight of your athlete movements and also of the movements of your opponent. This might lead to very, very huge data list, but at the end we have to get like an information, a very precise information list, which kind of parameters are important, and maybe we will find more data or more important parameters which are not being described right now. Well, in the future there is more potential for that. So there's just also like this visualization of the 3D of the where the ball stroke the plate. This could also be used for statistical analysis, and I hope you clearly understand that we have the chance to get all the information within one system or within one tracking method. But the way or what we have to do is we have to bring it back to our athletes and to perform that, because it's not been done right now in table tennis. I know that, but we have a big chance to now be able to do some kind of analysis we are not able to do in the past.